You're watching UNICEF television. It's a long, hot journey through the desert to get to the nearest market for villagers in Chad's northwestern Kanem region. Changing weather patterns here have led to severe droughts, crippling local agriculture and causing chronic food shortages, according to local assessments. The 2009 harvest was a disaster, yielding only enough grain to feed the region for 2 weeks. Severe food shortages combined with unbalanced diets and poor childcare practices have led to soaring malnutrition rates in Kanem. Adam Abdullahi, just over a year old, was in a critical condition when he was brought into this UNICEF-supported therapeutic feeding center in the district hospital of Mal. Here, he's receiving emergency care and is fed milk every 3 hours while being closely watched by health workers. A week after arriving at the centre, Adam's health is steadily improving. His mother spoke of eating just porridge made from millet every day during her pregnancy, leaving her weak after the birth and unable to care for her son properly. Adam's mother and grandmother stay with him at the feeding centre day and night.
For the last 10 years, all of our hard work in our fields has produced nothing because there's been little rain, so we have to buy maize from the market.
There are more than a dozen children admitted at this center where emergency therapeutic feeding takes place every day.
The severely malnourished children with secondary infections are referred to this center. Those that don't respond to treatment are also referred to this center. If this center did not exist, the situation would be catastrophic for the district of Mao.
Over 8,000 children have been treated at these centers since 2009, but the needs are still huge.
Unprecedented impact of lack of rainfalls has accelerated vulnerability and malnutrition rates.
Tackling malnutrition in remote areas is key here. In the village of Bara, 20 kilometers from Mao, a UNICEF-supported clinic provides monitoring and treatment for severely malnourished children. There's been a 25% increase in the number of children brought in between January and February 2010. Zara Hassan comes here every week with her malnourished two-year-old to receive supplies of plum peanut, a high-protein, high-energy peanut paste fortified with vitamins and minerals. The child is 3 kilos underweight and showing signs of improvement.
Nothing grows here. This hand has taken over and there is nothing left. The soil has gone and the land is now covered with sand.
The only patch of land left for farming is the oasis. With virtually no local produce on the market, most food items are transported into Mao from other parts of the country, leading to huge price increases and leaving thousands unable to feed their families and dependent on food aid. This is Salma Zulfikar reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.